Hello everyone. This lesson will be about the direct pronouns and indirect pronouns. So that would be the first part. I know that it's a pretty sensitive chapter. Let's say 99% of my students hate this chapter. But let's start slow. So I'm using Grammaire Progressive du Français, the beginner book. And so you can see the content, it's pretty cool. It's beginner, huh? So you don't have anything too complex here. And let's see if I can find the chapter about the direct pronouns first. So you see you have the passé composé, you have the future. You have different relatives. You have the negative. Je vais au cinéma. Ah, that's here. So you have the direct. They condemn les pronoms compléments directs. Or you can say pronoms directs. And les pronoms compléments indirects. So let's start with this for today. La page 142. Okay. I don't think that's this one. It's also replacing a location, hein, the pronoun y is also a pronoun. So, il le regarde, il la regarde, il les regarde. So be careful because in English when you check this verb, it's like to look at. So in English you have a preposition, but in French you don't. Okay, it's to regarder, there is no preposition. So basically I can say, il regarde le garçon, no preposition after the verb. So, il le regarde, il regarde la fille, il la regarde, il regarde les enfants, il les regarde. As long as a verb is not followed by a preposition, you will deal with what we call the pronom complément direct, les pronoms directs. Okay? Pour éviter de répéter un nom complément, on utilise un pronom complément. So, it's just to avoid any kind of repetition. So, to avoid any repetition, we use a pronoun. So, the definition of a pronoun will be, I replace a noun. Pronoun, replacing a noun. Okay? So, il regarde le garçon. Il le regarde. Il regarde le ciel. He's looking at the sky. Il le regarde. Il regarde la fille. Il la regarde. Il regarde la fontaine, the fountain. Il la regarde, il regarde les enfants, il les regarde, il regarde les oiseaux, il les regarde. Okay, so now, this pronoun is always placed before the noun, the verb, sorry. It's always before the verb. And if you want to add a negative form, you're going to keep the pronoun together with a verb. You cannot separate them. And so first, I'm going to read the example, so let me make it a bit bigger. So, I reuse the same article. Okay, this article, I drop the noun and I'm gonna bring it in front of the verb. Il le regarde, il le regarde, il la regarde, il la regarde, il les regarde, il les regarde. Il me regarde, he's looking at me. Il te regarde, he's looking at you. Il le regarde, he's looking at him or it. It can be it masculine. Il la regarde, he's looking at it, feminine, or he's looking at her, okay? Now, il nous regarde, he's looking at us. Il vous regarde, he's looking at you. So it can be you guys, it can be you sir, you ma'am, okay? Il les regarde, so it can be he's looking at them, but he's looking at it, pluriel form. Okay, it can be les oiseaux, the birds, okay, he's looking at the kids, he's looking at the birds. Now, il m'aime, he loves me, il t'aime, he loves you, il l'aime, he loves him or her, il nous invite, he invites us, il vous attend, he is waiting for you, you guys, you sir, you ma'am, il les adore, he adores it, ployon, or them. Okay, so, I mean, them, that would be them in general, even for objects or person. Now, Now, I'm not going to go through this stuff because it's not always making sense. It's just because the noun, I mean, the verb starts with a vowel, so we're going to have the M apostrophe, T apostrophe, or the L apostrophe. Now, except with the plural form, because that's what they meant here. Il les adore. Les cannot be turned into L apostrophe, otherwise it will be a singular form. So, let's go through this. I'm assuming the tool will work. Let's see. So, vous prenez le métro à 8 heures. So, you take the subway at 8. Oui, je le prends à 8 heures. So, the thing is to be like, le, I'm going to reuse it and put it here. Okay? Vous le prenez à 8 heures. Vous lisez le journal dans le métro. So, I'm going to reuse. Vous le lisez dans le métro. You read it on the subway. Vous regardez la télé le soir, vous la regardez le soir. Vous écoutez la radio le matin, vous... So, I'm not going to say vous la écoutez, but vous l'écoutez, L apostrophe. Vous faites les exercices tout seul. Vous les faites tout seul. OK. So, remplacez les noms par les pronoms le, la, les, again. Hein. So, here I have sa voiture. Il garde sa voiture dans la rue. So he parks his car on the street or in the street. So ça, we know it's a feminine form. So the article will be là. Il la garde dans la rue. Il achète le journal dans un kiosque. Il l'achète, L apostrophe, dans un kiosque. Il ouvre son courrier dans l'ascenseur. So he opens his mail in the elevator. Il, so again, it's a singular form, so it's le courrier, but le, L-E, will become L apostrophe. Il l'ouvre dans l'ascenseur, he opens it in the elevator. Il enlève ses chaussures dans l'entrée, he removes his shoes in the entrance. So it's a plural form, I cannot have L apostrophe, il les enlève, L-E-S. Okay, so if I want to write some answers. Elle. So, elle l'achète. She buys it. Okay. Elle l'ouvre. She opens it. It's a plural form. I cannot use the L apostrophe. Sorry. Elle les enlève. So, she removes them. The shoes. Elle prépare le repas dans la cuisine. Elle le prépare. Okay. As long as you know if it's masculine, singular, feminine, singular, you're gonna use le, la ou L apostrophe. But as long as you know it's a plural form, you're gonna use les, no matter what. Okay. No L apostrophe for the plural form. Now, transformer avec le ou la, selon le modèle. Continuer librement. So, un ticket de métro is le ticket de métro. So, je l'achète, I buy it. Je le composte, that is not composting, but it's more like to validate it. Okay, je le composte. Je le déchire. So, déchirer is to shred it, to take it apart, because you don't want somebody to reuse it. Et je le jette. There's a double T. Je le jette. I throw it. Une chemise. Chemise can be a blouse. So it's là. So je la mets. So I put it on. Je l'enlève. I removed it. Je la lave. I wash it. Je la lave. Je la repasse, to iron it, I iron it. So, je la repasse. Et je la range, I put it away. Ranger is to organize, to put things away. Let's go with this one. And I'm going to ask you guys to send me exercise 5 and 6 as a homework. Okay, so l'actrice, let me go through them number 4. So transformer avec le, l'aller. So we're not doing anything else. Maquiller, se maquiller, si tu put on makeup. Coiffer, tu brush, tu comb. Habiller, of course, it's s'habiller, se coiffer, se maquiller, se parfumer. Zeus en on, normalisé en on, reflexive verbs. But on la maquille is like one is putting on makeup, putting on her some makeup. Okay? So, on la maquille, so she's not doing it herself, somebody is doing it for her. Now, on la maquille, on la coiffe, so la replaces the actress, on la coiffe, on l'habille, the verb starts with an H on a vowel, so L apostrophe, on l'habille, et on la parfume. Okay. Les figurants, the figurants, on. So one, you know, help them, lead them, etc. So on les appelle. So somebody calls them. On les appelle. On les rassemble. To gather them. On les dirige. To lead them. L-E-A-D. And on les aide. We help them. Somebody help them. Now, le metteur en scène is like the director. Écouter, to listen. Respecter, to respect. Admirer, to admire. Aimer, to love, to like. So, on l'écoute. So, one listens to him. On le respecte. On l'admire. Et on l'aime. Okay? So I'm going to ask you to do exercise 5 and 6. You can send me the answers in my email because you know it. And if you have any questions, I can answer your questions or any doubts. Okay. So now, of course, this is all about the indirect pronouns. So il lui parle, il leur parle. It's like, we have the verb followed by a preposition, parler à quelqu'un, to talk to someone. Okay? So, il parle à Max, il lui parle. Il offre des fleurs à Katia, il lui offre des fleurs. And I know it lui, normally you should think it's him. But lui, as an indirect pronoun, can mean him or her, both. Il dit bonjour à ses amis. Il leur dit bonjour. Okay. So, lui is because, well, it's masculine or feminine. It's because we have a verb followed by the preposition à. Okay. Je téléphone à Pierre, je lui téléphone. Je téléphone à Marie, je lui téléphone. Je téléphone à mes cousins, je leur téléphone, pour les enfants. Je téléphone à mes cousines, je leur téléphone. So, I don't care if it's masculine or feminine. And I don't care if it's masculine or feminine in the singular form or the plural form. It's going to only be lui or leur. Now, the same drill, this pronoun, comes in front of the verb. So, Paul me téléphone, Paul calls me. Paul te téléphone, Paul calls you. Paul lui téléphone, Paul calls him or her. Paul nous Marie nous écrit, Marie writes to us, Marie vous écrit, Marie writes to you, sir, to you, ma'am, to you guys, and Marie leur écrit, Marie writes to them, okay? We say, il me téléphone, he calls me, but don't say, il téléphone à moi. That is really wrong here, okay? That's not gonna work. So, as a beginner level, we can say, well, if I'm parler à, écrire à, téléphoner à, répondre à, dire à, envoyer à, donner à, offrir à, talk to, call someone. But here we have the preposition à in French. So learn those guys. Tell to someone, give someone, offer, to send, to answer, respond, and write. Okay? In French, they are followed with a preposition à. Now, because it's a tiny bit more complex, I'm going to just go through one exercise and the rest will be a homework. If you are willing to do it. Now, répondez aux questions avec lui ou leur. Vous parlez à Julie, oui, je lui parle. Vous parlez à Paul et à Julie, so them, oui, je leur parle. Vous téléphonez à Teresa, oui, je lui téléphone. Vous écrivez à Louis, oui, je lui écris. Vous téléphonez à vos parents, oui, je leur téléphone. Et vous écrivez à vos amis, oui, je leur écris. OK? So, exercise 2, you can pause and you can write down the answers. Exercise 3, you can pause, you can write down the answers. Exercise 4, you pause, write down the answers. And exercise 5, you pause and you write down the answers. So what I did is page 145, 144, 143, and 142 of the book Grammaire Progressive du Français, the beginner one, which is an orange one. Okay? Let me know if you have any questions. If you have any doubts, let me know. And I'll talk to you soon. Au revoir.